Hello students, welcome to my channel. I'm Poonam Dua from M.A. Education Academy of Literature, and today we are here to cover some important questions of Victorian era in form of MCQs. I hope this will help you a lot to appear for any kind of English literature competitive exam. Please do not forget to share and subscribe my channel. Let us start with the questions now. Question number 1. Which Bronte sister wrote Wuthering Heights? Options: Branwell, Emily, Annie, Charlotte. The answer is option number 2, Emily Bronte. Wuthering Heights, Emily Bronte's only novel, was published in 1847 under the pseudonym Ellis Bell. It was written between October 1845 and June 1846, and Wuthering Heights in Annie Bronte's Agnes Grey were accepted by publisher Thomas Newby before the success of their sister's Charlotte's novel Jane Eyre. Next question. Which novel features the detecting skills of Sergeant Cuff? The options: The Moonstone, Dracula, Edwin Drood, Picture of Dorian Gray. The answer is option number A, The Moonstone. The Moonstone, written in 1868 by Wilkie Collins, is a 19th century British epistolary novel. It is generally considered to be the first detective novel, and this is the novel which established many of the ground rules of modern detective novels. The story was originally serialized in Charles Dickens' magazine All the Year Round. Sergeant Cuff, the fictional character, the detective in Wilkie Collins' mystery, The Moonstone, like Inspector Bucket in Charles Dickens' Bleak House. The character of Sergeant Cuff was based upon Inspector Jonathan Witcher, a Scotland Yard real-time detective. Next question. What poet wrote the lines, "Oh, to be in England now that April is there"? Answer options: Robert Browning, Matthew Arnold, Alfred Lord Tennyson, or William Morris. The answer is option number A, Robert Browning. Home Thoughts from Abroad is a poem by Robert Browning. It was written in 1845 while Browning was on a visit to northern Italy, and was first published in his Dramatic Romances and Lyrics. With this poem, Home Thoughts from Abroad, Robert Browning puts himself in the position of one who has been away from home and is missing it dearly. The speaker thus can be considered a traveler. In 1995, Home Thoughts was voted 46th in BBC poll to find the United Kingdom's favorite poems. Next question. Which novel bears the subtitle A Pure Woman? Agnes Grey, Jane Eyre, Mary Barton, or Tess of the Ubervilles? Answer is option number D, Tess of the Ubervilles. Tess of the Ubervilles, A Pure Woman Faithfully Presented, is a novel by Thomas Hardy. The poor peddler John Durbeyfield is stunned to learn that he is descendant of an ancient noble family, the Durbeyfields. Meanwhile, Tess, his eldest daughter, joins the other village girls in the May Day dance, while where Tess briefly exchanges glances with a young man. Published by the British Illustrated newspaper, The Graphic, in 1891, then in book form in 3 volumes in 1891 and as a single volume in 1892. Next question. Which novel has alternative title The Two Nations? North and South, Sibyl, Tale of Two Cities, or Jude the Obscure? answer is option number B, Sibyl. Sibyl or the Two Nations is an 1845 novel by Benjamin Disraeli, published in the same year as Frederick Engels' The Condition of Working Class in England in 1844. Sibyl traces the plight of working classes of England. Benjamin Disraeli also happened to serve as Prime Minister of United Kingdom twice. The next question, question number 6. Which of these novels is set in a large part in America? Martin Chuzzlewit, Middlemarch, The Netherworld, The Woodlanders. The answer is option number A, Martin Chuzzlewit. The Life and Adventures of Martin Chuzzlewit is a novel by Charles Dickens, considered the last of his picaresque novels. It was originally serialized between 1842 and 44. While he was writing it, Dickens told a friend that he thought it was his best work, but it was one of his least popular novels. Next question. Which poet asserted, "Each man kills the thing he loves"? George Meredith, Elegeron Charles Swinburne, Oscar Wilde, Dante Gabriel Rossetti. The answer is option number C, Oscar Wilde. The Ballad of Reading Gaol is a poem by Oscar Wilde, written in exile in Bernay-le-Grand after his release from Reading Gaol, and these lines are from this particular poem only. The next question, question number 8. Which Dickens novel features the London debtors' prison, Marshalsea? Oliver Twist, Dombey and Son, Bleak House, or Little Dorrit? The answer is option number D, Little Dorrit. Little Dorrit is a novel by Charles Dickens, originally published in serial form between 1855 and 1857. The story features Emmy Dorrit, youngest child of her family, born and raised in the Marshalsea prison for debtors in London. Next question, which poet wrote Modern Love? Dante Gabriel Rossetti, Oscar Wilde, George Meredith, Elegeron Charles Swinburne. The answer is option number C, George Meredith. Modern Love by George Meredith is a collection of 16 line sonnets about the failures of his first marriage. He reflects his own disillusionment after his wife Mary Ellen, the daughter of Thomas Love Peacock, left him for the painter Henry Wallace. The last question of this video, which Victorian author's real name was Mary Ann Evans? George Eliot, Clara Lucas Belfort, Elizabeth Gaskell, or Annie Bronte? Answer is option number A, George Eliot. Mary Ann Evans, known by her pen name George Eliot, was an English novelist, poet, journalist, translator, and one of the leading writers of Victorian era. The point of time when she was writing, it was not considered good to be a writer for females, so most of the females had to adopt pseudonyms. This must have been the scenario with George Eliot or Mary Ann Evans as well. I hope you liked the video. Please go back to the whole video again. Take down proper notes. You may find something new added to your knowledge. Please subscribe to our channel to gain more knowledge about English literature and contact to join our face-to-face classes. Thanks a lot for watching and best of luck for your exams.